Welcome back. Dressing up for the weekend with steam trains. Sounds intriguing. Would you believe it? Do you believe in tradition?
Yes.
What do you make of people who get dressed up in 40s gear and parade around a railway station for a weekend for a bit of fun?
I've not got any problem with that. It's fine.
Do you think it's good to keep those kind of traditions
alive? Of course it is, yes.
Why?
Because we're losing them.
Would you ever get dressed up in the gear from those days?
No.
Get your hair, get your hair done in
No, definitely not.
No, why not? Be good fun.
I do like the music. I think it's the music from that time, isn't it?
It is.
It brings you back.
Well, would you believe it? It all happens on the North Yorkshire Moors Railway, where they go to extraordinary lengths to roll back the years. Victoria Whittam now takes a step back in time.
Biggest date on the North Yorkshire Moors Railway calendar. Throughout this weekend, thousands of visitors will flood the platforms of stations along the line. More than just a day out, for some, this is a nostalgic trip down memory lane. For others, it's a chance to experience everything that was good about the Roaring Forties during Pickering's wartime weekend. It's 7 a.m. and as the sun rises over the platforms, a last-minute meeting is already well underway. For the past year, the Levisham Station volunteers, also known as the Wombles, have been planning events for this weekend. It's crucial that everything goes well. Poor weather and the credit crunch have significantly reduced visitor numbers throughout the summer.
The Wombles, well, it's the Levisham Station Group really by rights, and they started up in about 1970s, and in those days we didn't have very much money and Levisham was always the poor relation, never got anything. So what happened was that the Levisham Station Group would take anything that anyone else was throwing away and make it into something. So the other station groups decided to give us the nickname of the Wombles, and of course we just ran with it. We just thought it was hilarious, and so we now just laughingly say that when you join the Levisham Station Group, you are actually a Womble.
Who do you think you are kidding, Mr. Hitler, if you think we're on the run?
Across the station, the reenactors are getting ready for the display. Controversially, Levisham Station, or Levisham as it's known this weekend, becomes part of occupied France.
Who do you think you are kidding, Mr. Hitler?
The Germans tried to make it so that their concept was that this war against the Russians was a European crusade. So they tried to, and very successfully, managed to recruit quite a few soldiers from lands that they occupied to fight against the Russians. And so they made it this like European crusade. So this is what the concept of this weekend is, that it's France and it's a propaganda unit and they're trying to recruit French people to come and fight the Russians.
So you guys all dress up as German. Does anyone get kind of offended by that?
I say 99.999% of the time, no. You do get the odd person. I mean, I've spoken to little old ladies who worked in concentration camps, sweatshops, worked to death making uniforms like the ones we wear, and they'd never seen anybody wear one. They were absolutely fascinated by what we do. And they weren't offended. You know, it's just a uniform. We play a role. We're here to educate and entertain the public. That's about as deep as it goes, really.
It's 9:30 and the Wombles have been working very hard since the break of dawn to set up Levisham Station. As yet, these platforms remain deserted, but not for long, because a steam train packed full of thousands of visitors is already on its way. Oh, over by the carriages, Womble Tony has spotted a problem. Boulders are blocking the platform.
Right, Tony, we're going to have to try and push this forward first, and then we'll spin it round. It's just to give some access for the public.
Yeah.
Or better access, I should say. I live in Pickering, and I travelled on this railway up to about 6 months before I decided what group to join. And this one every time, I must admit. It's a nice, peaceful station. As everybody may know, it's based on 1912, and there's not a lot of modern stuff here. But what I like is the group. We're like a big, happy family. Whatever we do here, we're trying to get everything back to the 1912 era. You'll never find any Phillips screws on this station. It's all slotted screws as it was, no plastic, etc. That's the main thing, but this restoration is just non-stop. There's always something to do.
How's that look?
Yeah,
pretty good. The project we're doing is to build a replica of a North East Railway storage hood. Because the one we've got there is actually British Rail, so it's not really in pact with the rest of the station. So we're just building this really sort of... It would originally be built out of sleepers, and we've built it obviously in the same sort of appearance, but with a bit more modern techniques.
This timber is probably third hand. It was used probably as ship's timbers for hold lining. Then it was used to make a station platform at Warrenby outside Middlesbrough. Then we bought the station platform and reused it as a station platform. And when it got too rotten for that, we're cutting the sound bits out of it now to use it to build a shed. So it's probably had four uses as this timber.